Hello guys, my name is Russian Badger, and I would like to show you how I found Michael Jordan in Battlefield 4. So, I was spectating a buddy of mine on Dawnbreaker, and I noticed a guy in his squad by the name of Anal Strike Force. So, given a name like that, of course I had to investigate what his gameplay was all about, and he found this vaulting sweet spot where he jumped like 200 feet in the air. I think Air Jordans are about a 30-foot advantage. That is way beyond that. That's like parachute pants Air Jordans and jumping on a trampoline. And I thought that was impressive until he did it again. Now look, I'm not the perfect person that you might want to come to if you want to, you know, guesstimate or sort of estimate how high somebody is in the air. And I'm not exactly an ace at math, but that is thousands of meters in the air, all right? That is pretty high for somebody to be jumping or vaulting off of a flat surface without bending his knees. That's like the most impressive thing. And then, of course, later on, 5 minutes later in chat, he's taunting the anti-aircraft gun. He says, come and get me now, AA, do your job. And I look and he is like, this is totally off the rails, all right? This has evolved from, like, Michael Jordan dunking on somebody to Michael Jordan has now become a part of NASA. He is an what kind of astronaut jump did you just do, Mr. Anal Strike Force? Even he in chat is like, jeez, that's probably around 2,000 to 3,000 meters in the air. I don't think that anybody can jump that high without a seriously limited edition signed pair of Air Jordans, but I commend Michael Jordan for playing Battlefield 4 nonetheless. Now, something that I've had a lot of fun with recently is toying around with enemies that have no ability to kill you. So see, I'm in the AA, he can't insta-kill me, I'm gonna see what he does. What is he gonna do if he knows he's dead and he's just dancing around? And not, of course, I dealt with this guy accordingly, but it's so funny just to let them squirm before they die. Now here, I'm a little confused, alright? Any time that I play with Kia, I think it's inherent that I'm going to be a little confused, and I think you're as equally as confused. Like, Kia, are you trying to tow away a BTR with a car? Like, this is the best part anyways. Not only is this just ridiculous, but Kia just keeps driving like there's nothing going on with his Latips Fedora neckbeard emblem guy. I don't even know what the deal is. Now, of course, I want to break him free because this is already creeping me out, and that results in two people dying and Kia ending up in the water. So thanks for whatever that was, Kia. A little bit later, I think it was like two games later, I was opening up battle packs, and I got an exclamation point? Exclamation mark? Okay, that's not that weird, and obviously with gold battle packs, most of the time I'm just expecting a bunch of 25, yeah, 25, 25. I got a hundo, or a hunted, if you want to say it that way. That's not all that surprising, but then, wait, what was that? Wait, what? I got a semicolon for my Battlelog emblem? Is this really what they're giving away with gold battle packs now? Semicolons? Am I gonna get, like, parentheses and brackets next? Is this really why we grind through levels, like, hundreds of hours to get all these gold battle packs so we can have semicolons? I don't get it. But another observation that I had recently was just the chat. Now, so oftentimes, you know, Bagel, please sign my German Shepherd, and both enemies and teammates don't really like me all that much, and sometimes, okay, all the hate in chat, sometimes it is warranted. Like, if I Sarai helicopter right out of spawn, yeah, you know what, I probably deserve to get called names. I'm not going to refute that. But then, even other times, teammates will try to compliment me on a nice shot, like a nice Sarai shot, and then they'll spell things incorrectly, and then they'll try to, like, backpedal and like, come on, Taco Cat, what are you, Taco Cat, please. Taco Cat, just spell it with a G next time. It's not that hard. But I have to say, this tops them all. If you are that mad, you say, fuck this shit, I'm going to make dinner, you know what, you are a new platinum level of mad. You are, like, first class, you get to board early and sit in the lounge level of mad. But apparently music inspired his dinner of dinosaur chicken nuggies, so I think everything ended up okay with salty or slippery sea slug. This guy, I don't understand. I think he was doing some kind of Mortal Kombat dance. I'm not familiar. And the final thing that I would like to share with you is a little bit of a glitch spot that music seems to have found. So basically, there's like this little pillar on the side of Dawnbreaker, and if you insert yourself into it, you can see the inner workings of what looks like the entire map. It's a little creepy. Now, it became even more creepy when music did this little thing here, but I'm certainly terrified.